Namaste children, welcome to today's mathematics class. How far is your house from your school? 1 kilometer, good. What is the length of your mathematics textbook? 27 centimeters, okay. So, you have learned distance between two places, length of an object can be expressed in kilometers, centimeters. What is the weight of your school bag? 3 kgs. Very good. What is the weight of your lunch box? 250 grams. Okay. So, you have learnt weight of an object can be expressed in kilograms, grams. Now, watch this video. Children, you have seen in the video, children are drinking milk with different sizes of mugs. Today, I had my milk with this mug. Did you also have the same size of mug? No, you had with small size of mug. Did your father also had with the same size of your mug? No, his mug is bigger than your mug. Okay. Children, are all these mugs of same size? No, they are of different sizes. The quantity of milk that this mug holds is the capacity of this mug. Now, see different capacities of mugs. Today, after going home, try to find out different capacities of containers from your home. The quantity of milk present in this cup is the volume of the milk. Let us see different volumes of liquid present in same size of mug. Watch this video of purchasing milk.
Uncle, today we want 1 liter milk. Uncle, please today give me 500 milliliters milk. Uncle, please give me 250 milliliters of milk. Thank you.
How do your father or mother purchases milk in your house? In terms of packets? Okay. Milkman comes to your house and gives you milk in measuring jars? Good. How much quantity of milk is purchased in your house today? 500 milliliters. Okay. This 500 milliliters milk is the capacity of that packet. Today, we are going to learn one of the interesting topics, jugs and mugs. This container is called jug. This jug can hold more volume of liquid. You all might have seen jugs are being used to serve water, milk, etc. in functions. It will help you to store liquid for few servings. This container is called mug. This will hold liquid lesser than this jug. These mugs you will use to drink your tea, milk, juice, etc. Children, do you remember wedding in Bunny's family last year in your third standard? Bunny and Bunno decided to have a party 1 year after their wedding. In that party, the guests are being served sweet dish called kheer as per their capacity. First, elephant wanted to drink 50 liters of kheer. Now, giraffe came for asking kheer. How much do you think that giraffe can drink? Is it more than 50 liters? No. Good. Why do you think that giraffe cannot drink more than elephant drinks? Because the capacity of giraffe's stomach is less than that of elephant's. Now, it is the turn of cow. How much do you think that cow can drink? Is it less than giraffe? Good. Why do you think that cow can drink less than giraffe? Because the capacity of cow's stomach is less than that of giraffe. The donkey was surprised and expressed his doubt whether 500 milliliters is more than a liter. Then the fox says, 1 liter is 1000 milliliters, so 500 milliliters is half of a liter. Let us see how 500 milliliters is half of a liter. We have already seen this is 500 milliliters measuring cylinder. This is 1000 milliliters measuring cylinder. We now see the measurement mentioned on this measuring cylinder. Observe carefully. Till here 100 milliliters, till here 200 milliliters, till here 300 milliliters, till here 400 milliliters, till here 500 milliliters, till here 600 milliliters, till here 700 milliliters, till here 800 milliliters, till here 900 milliliters, and till here 1000 milliliters. We now take 500 milliliters of water into this measuring cylinder. Observe carefully, children. Water level in this measuring cylinder reached up to 500 milliliters. So, this is 500 milliliters of water. We now transfer this 500 milliliters of water into 1000 milliliters cylinder. Please remember, I have transferred once. Once again, I will fill this 500 milliliters cylinder with water. Children, once again, observe carefully. Water level reached up to 500 milliliters. We have taken 500 milliliters of water into this measuring cylinder. Now, I transfer this water into this 1000 milliliters measuring cylinder. Water level in this measuring cylinder reached up to 1000 milliliters. So, volume of water in this measuring cylinder is 1000 milliliters. What we did? We transferred with this 500 milliliters of water twice to fill this 1000 milliliters. 1000 milliliters is nothing but 1 liter. Since we transferred twice with 500 milliliters to fill this 1000 milliliters, 500 milliliters is half of 1000 milliliters. That is nothing but 500 milliliters is half of 1 liter. Then 10 frogs came together by hopping, asking for 100 milliliters each. Children, do you know how much is 100 milliliters? Let us see. This is 100 milliliters measuring cylinder. Let us observe the measurement mentioned on this. Up to here 10 milliliters, up to here 20 milliliters, up to here 30 milliliters, up to here 40 milliliters, up to here 50 milliliters, up to here 60 milliliters, up to here 70 milliliters, up to here 80 milliliters, up to here 90 milliliters, and up to here 100 milliliters. Children, this much is 100 milliliters. Children, do you know how much of 10 times of 100 milliliters? Let us see. Children, we have seen this is 100 milliliters measuring cylinder. We now fill this cylinder with water. Please observe here. In this cylinder, water level reached up to 100, so this is 100 milliliters. Now, we transfer this 100 milliliters into this 1000 milliliters cylinder. Please remember, I poured once. Again, we fill this 100 milliliters measuring cylinder with water. Children, again observe here, water level reached 100 milliliters, so 100 milliliters of water is present in this measuring cylinder. We now pour this 100 milliliters into this 1000 milliliters. Please remember, we have poured twice. Again, we fill this 100 milliliters with water. Children, observe carefully, water level reached in this cylinder up to 1000 milliliters. So this is 1000 milliliters water. What we did? We poured with 100 milliliters cylinder into this 1000 milliliters cylinder 10 times. That means 10 times of 100 milliliters is equal to 1000 milliliters. That is nothing but 10 times of 100 milliliters is equal to 1 liter. Then an ant came by asking only 1 milliliter. Children, do you know how much of 1 milliliter is? Let us see. Children, this is syringe. Let us observe the measurement mentioned on this syringe. Up to here 0.5 milliliters, up to here 1 milliliters, up to here 1.5 milliliters, up to here 2 milliliters, and up to here 2.5 milliliters. Children, this much is 1 milliliter. Children, this much is 1 milliliter. Children, now you tell me, how many milliliters of kheer 1000 ants can drink? 1000 into 1 ml is equal to 1000 ml. So 1000 ants can drink 1000 ml of kheer. Now the donkey is trying for different ways of adding up to 1 liter. We now take 500 milliliters of water into this measuring cylinder. What we did, we transferred with this 500 milliliters of water twice to fill this 1000 milliliters. Let us try one more way of adding up to 1 liter. Children, observe carefully here. This is 250 milliliters measuring cylinder. We now fill this 250 milliliters measuring cylinder with water. Observe carefully, water level reached here up to 250 milliliters. We now pour this 250 milliliters water into this 1 liter measuring cylinder. Remember, we have poured once with 250 milliliters measuring cylinder into this 1 liter measuring cylinder. Once again, we will pour water into this 250 milliliters measuring cylinder up to 250 milliliters measurement. Children, again observe carefully. We have taken 250 milliliters water into this measuring cylinder. We now pour this water into this 1 liter measuring cylinder. Children, observe here carefully. Water level reached here up to 500 milliliters. How much more we have to pour in this 1 liter measuring cylinder to reach 1 liter? Good. 500 milliliters more we have to pour. Now, we have taken 500 milliliters measuring cylinder, we will pour water into this measuring cylinder. Children, observe here carefully. We have taken 500 milliliters of water into this. We now pour this 500 milliliters water into this 1 liter measuring cylinder. Children, observe carefully here, water level in this measuring cylinder reached up to 1000 milliliters. So, volume of water in this measuring cylinder is 1000 milliliters. So, 250 milliliters plus 250 milliliters plus 500 milliliters is equal to 1000 milliliters. Is it not interesting? Shall we try one more way? As you all know, this is 100 milliliters measuring cylinder. We now fill this with water. Children, observe carefully. Water level reached here up to 100 milliliters. We now pour this 100 milliliters water into this 1000 milliliters cylinder. As you all know, this is 500 milliliters measuring cylinder. We now fill this measuring cylinder with water. Children, observe carefully. Water level reached in this measuring cylinder up to 500 milliliters. We now pour this 500 milliliters of water into this 1 liter measuring cylinder. Children, observe carefully here. Water level reached up to 600 milliliters. Now can you please tell me how much more I have to fill so that it will reach up to 1000 milliliters? Very good, 400 milliliters. We now take 500 milliliters measuring cylinder and pour water up to 400 milliliters. Children, observe carefully. Water level reached here up to 400 milliliters. We now pour this 400 milliliters into 1 liter measuring cylinder. Children, observe carefully here. Water level in this measuring cylinder reached up to 1000 milliliters. So 100 milliliters plus 500 milliliters plus 400 milliliters is equal to 1000 milliliters. Children, look at these things which you get in terms of packets and bottles. Can you please tell me volume of liquid present in these things? How much volume will be present in this? 100 milliliters? Let us check. Look at here. It is written 100 milliliters. Very good. Volume of liquid present in this bottle is 100 milliliters. What is the volume of liquid present in this packet? 150 milliliters? Let us check. It is written here 150 milliliters. Very good. What is the volume of liquid present in this bottle? 300 milliliters. Let us see. It is written here 300 milliliters. Good. Volume of liquid present in this bottle is 300 milliliters. What is volume of milk present in this packet? 500 milliliters. Let us see. It is written here 500 milliliters. Very good. Can you please tell me volume of oil present in this bottle? 1 liter. Good. Volume of oil present in this bottle is 1 liter. This is 1 liter bottle. Children, now you make your own list of things which are available in terms of packets and bottles and their capacity. Dear children, let us summarize what we have learned today. We have learned today concept of capacity, concept of volume, estimation of volume of liquids and verify them by actual measurement, establish the relationship between milliliters and liters, explore different combinations of milliliters to make 1 liter, estimate the volume of liquid in different containers, identify the volume of liquids in different containers, solves problem involving in daily life situations related to volume involving 4 fundamental operations. Dear children, I hope you all have enjoyed today's class. Be safe and take care. Thank you very much.